गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट सेंटेंसेस इन द प्रीवियस चैप्टर, यू ऑल नो हाउ टू फ्रेम द सेंटेंसेस। वी हैव स्टडीड द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ सेंटेंसेस, दैट इज व्हेन अ ग्रुप ऑफ वर्ड्स व्हेन जॉइंड टुगेदर एंड दे मेक्स कंप्लीट सेंस इज कॉल्ड अ सेंटेंस। सो every sentence comprises of two parts, one is subject and the other one is predicate. Now let me introduce you about the subject, that is what or whom the sentence is about, and the predicate is the part that tells something about the subject. For example, the boys are running. In this sentence, the subject is the boys and the predicate is are running. For whom we are talking about? The boys. And what the boys are doing? They are running. So are running is predicate and the boys is subject. So now we will study a table. For example, cows are grazing in the field. In this sentence, we have cows and what are they doing? Are grazing in the field. So the subject is cows and the predicate is are grazing in the field. I am working on the computer. In this sentence, we are talking about I and the sentence is about I. So I here is subject and what I am doing? I am working on the computer. So this is predicate. So a subject is a noun or a pronoun. It can be one word or more than one word. For example, in the sentences which I have told you, like cows and I, these both are one word, and Akshay and his friends, this is more than one word. And the predicate tells us about the subject's action. It may also be one word. For example, gallop, or it can be more than one word, like are grazing in the field. Now the next part is when the predicate precedes the subject. In the sentence, we usually generally say subject comes before predicate. In the first part, we read about the subject, and in the last part of the sentence, we read about the predicate. So, a sentence is inverted to lay emphasis on the predicate. It means a sentence can be inverted so that a special emphasis should be given on the predicate. So in such type of sentences, the predicate comes before the subject. It means predicate comes earlier and the subject comes later on. For example, we have Jim sat under the tree. Here the subject is Jim. Whom we are talking about? That is Jim. And what he is doing? He sat under the tree. So when we want to invert the sentence, when the predicate precedes the subject, it will be under the tree, comma, sat Jim. The dog came down the stairs. In this sentence, the subject is the dog. And what the dog is doing? Came down the stairs. If we invert the sentence, it becomes down the stairs, comma, came the dog, when the predicate precedes the subject. Some flowers are in the vase. In the vase are some flowers. In the similar way, the last sentence is, Bill said, I am hungry. Whom we are talking about? Bill. And what Bill is doing? He is hungry. So, to invert the sentence, to lay emphasis on the predicate, we say, I am hungry, said Bill. Thank you, students. So, we have discussed about sentences and subject and predicate. I hope you all have understood how to form a sentence, how to frame a sentence, and how to find subject and predicate in the sentence, and how to invert the sentence. It means when the predicate will come first and when the subject will come at last. Thank you, class. Do the exercises which are given in the end and learn them also.